Raw material deposits can be found on land as well as in the oceans. To search for them, seismic measurements are carried out on land and water. On land, so-called vibro-sized trucks are used as vibration sources. Long chains of seismic receivers, namely geophones, record the signals at fixed positions. In marine environments, special underwater sound sources are used. The most commonly used source is known as an air gun. The receivers at sea, namely hydrophones, are drawn by ships on long chains at a constant distance from the sound source. The layout geometry of sources and receivers is different for these applications on land and at sea. But how exactly are they arranged? And how, from the seismic records collected in this way, properties of the subsurface, such as the propagation velocity of seismic waves, can be deduced? Hello and welcome. In this video, I show you some additional steps in how to handle seismic data. This is referred to as processing. I present various types of recording geometries, and you see what arrangements of receivers and sources are available that are typically used in reflection seismics. I show you the advantages they have and where they can be applied. Then I use a simple example to illustrate how the average propagation velocity in the subsurface can be calculated from the seismic records. This process is called velocity analysis. It is the first important step on the way to analyzing the complex structure of the subsurface. The two examples from the very onset illustrate a fundamental distinguishing feature between the various measuring geometries. On land, geophones are stationary. On sea, hydrophones are often drawn along chains, so-called streamers, behind the source. The seismic source on land can therefore be positioned between the receivers, but in marine seismics using streamers, this is not possible. In modern reflection seismic measurements, sources and receivers are arranged over a wide area and not in a line to explore the subsurface in 3D. In order to structure the evaluation, special lines from this measuring grid are normally selected and further processed. This selection is referred to as sorting and produces a certain measurement geometry. How the sources and receivers are specifically arranged you will see now. In marine seismics, hydrophones are typically pulled behind a source on streamers. The geometry used here therefore corresponds to a source with a constant spacing to the receivers. This geometry is referred to as common shot gather, or one with a common shot position. While the whole system moves over the sea, the distances between the air gun and the hydrophones remain constant. With this arrangement, a subsurface structure can be revealed up to about halfway between the source and the most distant measuring point. Both in marine and land seismics, one also uses the reverse version. This is called common receiver gather and corresponds to gather with a common receiver position. This arrangement is used, for example, when instruments on the ocean floor are used. The air gun shots are therefore varied with respect to the position on the sea surface. Because deposits of raw materials are often located at layer boundaries, it is important to determine their inclination within the subsurface. Seismic waves are reflected at layer boundaries, which are therefore referred to as reflectors. For the determination of the angle of inclination, a gather can be employed which uses constant source receiver distances. Why? I show you now. This source receiver distance is called offset, and the corresponding gather with a common distance is referred to as common offset. An inclined reflector under a constant common offset geometry produces a larger travel time as the depth of the reflector increases. A special variation of this is the zero offset configuration. Here, the source and the receiver are located in the same position. This is merely a theoretical arrangement, since in reality, it is impossible for the source and the receiver to be located in the same position. The zero offset arrangement is rather a gather variant, which is used only for modeling calculations. It is also used to derive true subsurface structures, also referred to as migration. For real measurement data, this can be simulated by stacking. For horizontal reflectors and homogeneous media, they form an arbitrary point in the subsurface directly above on the Earth's surface. The most common gather is based on a common midpoint in the subsurface and is referred to as common midpoint, or in short, CMP. In the case of a horizontal reflector in a homogeneous medium, the following applies. All paths are reflected to a common point at a subsurface. This gather makes it particularly easy to amplify signals from this single reflection point and to conceal other effects. How can the CMP gather be used to determine the wave velocity in the subsurface? Here I would like to show you the example of a horizontal reflector in a homogeneous medium. The medium should have a constant propagation velocity V0. For this, I add the travel time curve of the CMP profile to the diagram. Each path from a source to a receiver requires a certain time t, shown here as a point in the travel time diagram. The further a ray passes through the homogeneous medium, the longer is its travel time. If all points are connected to a line, a travel time curve is produced. In this case, it is a hyperbola. This illustrates how long a wave needs to get from the source to the receiver when it is reflected at a common reflection point. In practice, seismograms are arranged vertically to form a seismic profile. That looks like this. For illustrative purposes, the positive deflections are colored in black. If h is the thickness of the layer and x is the distance between the source and the receiver, the hypotenuse of the triangle is half of the travel distance. This then applies. A is equal to the square root of h squared plus x half squared. Since the velocity v0 is constant, for the squared travel time this follows. T squared is equal to 2a divided by v0 squared, which is equal to 2h divided by v0 squared plus x divided by v0 squared. The first term corresponds to the square of t0. This is the travel time of the perpendicular ray standing vertically on the reflector. In this simple case, it propagates vertically. From the curvature of the hyperbola, the velocity v0 can be read off. In reality, additional paths occur naturally in addition to the illustrated reflections. The associated seismic waves may also be reflected or refracted by other layer boundaries. Or they may pass directly to the receiver. Such signals are unwelcome here. They should be suppressed, while the desirable reflection signals should be amplified. For this purpose, among other things, one can use the normal move-out correction, NMO. This corrects the travel time curve to the travel time of the perpendicular, and thus also to the different offset distances. The NMO initiates a temporal displacement of the seismogram by a time delta t. As a result, the signals of the reflection arrive at the same time as that of the perpendicular. The NMO correction delta t depends on the offset x, and is derived from travel time t of x minus travel time of the perpendicular t0, which is equal to the square root of x divided by v0 squared plus t0 squared minus t0. As you can see in the image, the correction displaces the desired signals on a straight timeline. In the following steps of seismic processing, the individual seismograms are added, which is also called stacking. In this procedure, the reflection signal is amplified and other signals appear weaker. The reflection at several layers leads to various hyperbolic travel time curves. Further calculations allow the velocities of the individual layers to be derived. In reality, of course, the subsurface is much more complex, and a simple velocity analysis is only the first step. An accurate picture of the subsurface can be deduced using time-consuming methods such as migration, travel time tomography, or waveform inversions. In this video, you have learned about the different gathers used in reflection seismics. Common shot gathers are typically used in marine seismic surveys. Common midpoint gathers are used for measurements on land and at sea. The sorting of reflection seismic measurements is an important step of seismic processing, which allows large amounts of data to be evaluated in a structured manner. Plotting travel time curves allows the calculation of an average propagation velocity for seismic waves. The normal move-out correction then corrects travel time differences caused by different source-receiver offsets. It therefore correlates the desired reflections. These simple techniques form the basis for computer-based analyses of large measuring campaigns leading to the detailed 3D imaging of the subsurface. Migration is thereby the last step in processing.